Good afternoon. This is Steve Kimbrough. We are here in Queens, New York for a new organization that is just being launched. I have the president and the vice president, Jamie and Alvin Hartley. Well, not Jamie and Alvin Hartley, well, but you know, I'll let them introduce themselves. But this is an incredible new e-commerce chamber organization, African-American and Latino Chamber of Commerce. So I first of all, I want the two of you to introduce yourselves, president and vice president of the organization, and make sure you keep that mic nice and close
yes,
when you're talking.
My name is Jamie Ortiz. I am the current chapter president of the New York Latin Black and Latino Council.
Steve, my name is Alvin Hartley. I'm the vice president of the National Black and Latino Council, New York. That's who we are.
Nice. Now tell me what this organization is about. Like, what's the brainchild behind launching this? What's the need? Why are you doing this? We'll start with you, Jamie.
Well, we're trying to, get in the ethnic market. Minority businesses, probably the fastest growing commerce in right now in the last 10 years. Latino market has grown about 30% in the last 10 years. Minority businesses, women businesses,
absolutely,
they all are growing at record pace. So we want to harness that energy and represent.
So with the growth of that, you feel a need to get female-owned businesses and Latino and African-American businesses.
That's correct.
Kind of exposed into mainstream e-commerce.
Well, we want to mentor those businesses. We want to nurture them so that, sometimes when you go so quickly, you need to, certain things get lost along the way. And we'd like to make sure that, that we grab everything that we can.
Let me see if I can jump in. You don't mind, do you?
Yeah, jump in, brother.
Here's the thing about it.
Speaking to that.
Here's the thing about it, black and Latino markets. Great business people. But your business can't grow if you don't take yourself not only within your culture, but even take yourself out of your culture so that who cares who pays, who buys the service. But anybody that's buying that black and Latino service, no matter who's buying it, helps that business grow. With the council, one in Atlanta, Georgia, one in Washington, now here in New York City, we get to travel back and forth and meet the businesses in other cities and states. That's allowing us to grow, no matter if it's ethnic or general. But it's the ethnic market that needs to grow more. Bring that dollar back in. Like Jamie and I said, if you look between the Hispanic and African-American, that's about $2 billion, $2 trillion. Am I right, Jamie?
Affirmative.
That's about $2 trillion.
Mm-hmm.
So it's about bringing that money in, helping the business grow, and can make our contribution to America every single day.
Yeah, right. We're also, looking to expand the networking, expand horizons of all of our brothers and sisters so that this way, we're going to go global. We're going to go, we can reach out on a whole different plateau. And that's what this is all about. We shake hands. We get out there. And big businesses are looking for savvy people in networking. They're looking for that. They're looking for, fulfilling, minority quotas. And it sounds cold, but it's a cold, hard fact.
It's good. It's good business.
It's good business. Not at all.
And speaking global, like, what are your goals as far as like branching out, creating more chapters?
Let me leave it.
East Coast thing, a national thing.
Absolutely.
What's your goal?
What's happening right now is because
Use this hand.
Okay. What's happening basically is that in in the markets, like I mentioned, Atlanta, Georgia, we're going to grow slow. It's no rush. Grow slow. Now, think about it. Maybe in a couple of years, we have 10, 15 chapters. But look at all the businesses traveling in those states to do business with these businesses in those states. It's a gradual growth, but it's worth it.
Nice. And as far as going global, you're looking at other countries as well, right?
Well, I mean, that's a natural. I mean, once we got the formula down here in the United States, you know, the whole universe is ours, pretty much. We are looking forward to seeing that our Washington, D.C. chapter open tomorrow. We are looking towards, you know, we're checking out the Miami market. That's going to explode for us very shortly. I know that's in the works. I'd like to see, even once we seal up the East Coast with Boston,
we'll Philadelphia.
Philadelphia. We can even mention Charlotte if we wanted to. But
yes, sir.
Let's move west. You know,
how many of these events do you plan on doing?
Right now, we're going to be taking a slow. We're going to be doing a few more for night for 2014.
Right, that's correct.
And then we'll move for 2015. So we're going to be planning a lot. Today's a soft sell. Today is an installation. It's a soft sell. It's a soft introduction. Am I right? Mm-hmm. And then from there, we'll build it.
Right. I mean, we're looking to do another. We're looking to do another event in July. We'd like to do a Ethnic Taste of New York, where we can, you know, explore and network and socialize and the sounds and the foods of our cultures. And I mean, that expands our horizons.
Nice. Right. So where can we reach you on the web if we want to find out where you are?
Well, let me read the card, right? You can go to the BlackLatinoCouncil.org. BlackLatinoCouncil.org.
Three words.
Okay.
Right? Oh,
yeah,
sorry.
BlackLatinoCouncil.org.
Yeah. Oh, sorry about that. BlackLatinoCouncil.
We will have the New York chapter up soon on our we'll have our own website shortly. And, you know, and then that'll be a resource for everybody, you know. And hopefully, you know, it'll help people develop their businesses.
Well, there you have it. If you are looking to get involved in Latino and minority businesses, this is a place that you can start. We have the National Black and Latino Council of America kicking off right here, the New York chapter, right here in Queens at this wonderful establishment called City Ribs. And the food is great here, and
great
the ambiance and the Live80s is all good. So we're glad that they could participate and help you guys kind of launch your organization.
Thank you, Steve.
Thank you.
All right. Well, get out there, throw some cards out.
Got it.
Mix it up.
Exactly.
All right.